And tonight's Halloween, come dine with me.
The cat's gone nuts.
There is a spirit in this house.
The return of Freddy Krueger.
You're my girlfriend now, Nikki.
I freaked out.
A dodgy druid.
You are incredibly annoying.
I hope tonight there will be a bit more common decency.
And a very worried wag.
Hey!
As four celebrities compete. For a £1,000 charity prize.
They tasted like a charcoal briquette, you know, with urine on it.
This is going.
How about you?
I'm fine, thanks. Our first host is the star of horror classic A Nightmare on Elm Street, Robert Englund, known to fans as Freddy Krueger.
Freddy's only in your dreams and your subconscious. He knows what you've been thinking. He knows if you've been good or bad. He knows what's in your underwear drawer.
No wonder he's got problems.
I'm not a scary guy. I'm not a monster. I'm a little shy. I think most actors are.
Yeah, right. Over from the States, Robert's borrowing a gothic mansion for the day, as you do.
I hope my guests aren't afraid tonight. I hope that they're willing to surrender, you know, to Mr. Krueger's kitchen.
I'm sure they'll do whatever you want. For dessert, he'll be serving decaying sodas.
This is an American. Because of soda.
Anyone would think you're psychic. Our second competitor is TV medium Sally Morgan.
My work is a window into many people's fear.
Whoa. Sounds a bit like Freddy.
Is there someone called Pat in spirit?
To be a good medium, you've got to have empathy, bucket loads of compassion.
Anything I can do for you?
I think she's all right, actually. Robert will be making his decaying sodas tonight, so it's on to the starter, painless spinach salad.
I love spinach. Good for Popeye, good for reading air.
Sorry, who? Contestant number three is cage fighter, druid and former Mr. Katie Price, Alex Reid.
Oh, yeah!
I get a little bit of stick in the media. Monkey boy, potato head, cross-dressing cage fighter.
Oh, yeah! He also likes dressing up as a woman called Roxanne.
You know, it sticks and stones and all that, but sometimes it does upset me.
Oh, not such a tough guy then.
I do get scared. Someone jumps out at me. Whoa! I'm like, where did that girly scream come from?
Roxanne? Back in the kitchen, Robert's preparing bacon for his spinach salad.
Get down there, my little piggy. I'm sorry, I turned into you-know-who there for a second.
You must be fun to live with. He chops the bacon ready for later, before frying onions in the bacon fat.
I'm not going to be evil, I'm not going to be rude, I'm going to be elegant, and I'm going to be everyone's favorite host.
Thank God for that!
Not!
Hey! Oh, Robert will reheat the onions and assemble his salad later. Next, he's chopping pepper, rather cack-handedly, for his main fleshy fish melt. Ooh, yummy.
Ugh. It's making me cough. How weird.
Spooky.
I've got a really bad gag reflex and that's actually making me want to gag.
Charming. Our lineup's completed by former Page 3 girl turned model Nicola McLean.
Love it, love it, Kate.
I hate horror movies. I would describe myself as a scaredy cat, definitely.
Blimey, you're in for a tough week. Good job you're not scared to speak your mind.
That's it.
I just tend to say what other people are thinking. I don't kind of have a filter.
Oh, I think you've got something on your face. Anyway, back in Freddy's lair, Robert's mixing tuna, pepper, pickles, spring onions, mayo and mustard.
So I can mix. That's a fleshy fish melt. A la Robert Englund.
Yeah, sorry, are you in character here or not? Either Robert or Freddy will serve it on toast with melted cheese tonight. And there's one last request for his guests.
The dress code being your worst nightmare is really honestly making me panic. That's a bit frightening.
I want Dracula ringing my doorbell. I want Frankenstein. I want Pinhead. I want little baby Freddy Krueger's out there.
How about the Redonator? He's pretty scary. Food prepped. Robert's got time to get ready.
Go change.
Or polish the cutlery before unleashing the terror on guest number one, a petrified Nicola McLean. Uh-oh.
My worst nightmare is Freddy Krueger.
Honestly, I freaked out like I had a mini anxiety attack.
Please.
Well, it looks like it.
I've been cooking all day. Please enter.
Is this how you talk? Or can you speak?
No, I'm teasing.
Oh my God, hold high.
Hi, shake.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
I was like, is this how he's going to speak to me all night? Because if that's how he is, then I'm going to have to go home.
I'm literally shaking. What a freak am I? Literally, you're like my worst nightmare ever.
And it's nice to meet you too.
Are you hungry?
No, actually, I feel rather sick.
What a great start. Next in, and hopefully slightly more ballsy, it's Sally Morgan. Oh, not you as well.
Hello, man of your dreams, what can I say?
Yeah, that did frighten me, actually.
Yeah, we saw.
And then he was, like, sort of... just like a regular guy, but I know it was Freddy.
It's Mr. Krueger to you!
Just keep him happy, Sally.
Hi.
Hi, I'm Sally.
Last in, is that Chianti? I think it's Alex Reid.
Hannibal the Cannibal.
No, it's the Redonator, a.k.a. Roxanne.
Yeah, you know who I am.
Yeah, we do know who you are. Yeah.
And you, my friend, are a childhood fantasy nightmare.
I've met Alex a couple of times.
Was he wearing the mask?
As soon as I seen him, it was all about him, all about him, all about him. So, you know.
You like him then?
Wonderful.
It's a delicious food.
Yeah.
Coming up. It's Robert's turn for a surprise.
Alex is a transvestite.
Shocked is what I am.
Alex is under fire.
He's self-indulgent.
Even Nick and McLean said some not nice things.
And Nicola, let's go.
No.
She's going to need tenors tomorrow, and I don't mean a £10 note.
It's a celebrity Halloween special, and first host Robert Englund, a.k.a. Freddy Krueger, is cooking dinner in a bid to win £1,000 for charity.
Come alive, my little onions, come alive!
He's preparing his starter by reheating onions and flash-frying some greens.
Oh, I think it's going to be fun. I'm looking forward to it. I might really have a chance.
That's the spirit! He adds egg whites, bacon bits and abracadabra, painless spinach salad.
This is the painless salad, isn't
it? It's painless because you just flash it really quick in the pan.
Bon appetit.
And it's supposed to be wilted.
It was just a bit tasty, and it was very light on your tummy.
Oh, easy on your tumsy-wumsy, was it?
So he ate my salad, so I'm eating everything he makes. I'm telling you right now.
It wasn't amazing, but it was nice, and I love him.
I thought you were terrified of him. Anyway, turns out Alex and Sally have a mutual acquaintance.
I was told by Kate you said some not nice things about me. Katie Price I was married to.
But I remember saying to her, I can see you marrying this man, but if you do, it won't even last 2 years.
Oh, that's what...
Don't even go there.
Yeah.
Well, obviously, she told Alex that. And how long did it last?
About a few weeks short of a year.
There you go. I rest my case, basically.
I think that he's possibly feeling rather intimidated by me, and I feel sorry for that.
Yeah, try a softer approach.
Alex is a transvestite.
Not that!
And gets a lot
and
of
a
comfort.
Boxer.
Oh, and
no,
a cage boxer.
I am the
cage
cross-dressing cage fighter. Yes.
They are attacking you in the press.
Yes.
And why should they attack you? You're not doing anything wrong.
I was like, oh, well, I'm in the trenches here.
I hope that you guys didn't see me put my fist in my mouth, but I'm fine with it, you know. I mean, I'm not judging. I'm just... Shocked is what I am. No, I'm teasing you. I was just, you know, I was kind of flabbergasted by that one.
You could never tell. For his main, Robert spreads a tuna mix over toast, adds cheese and melts.
Glorious. No, yes, no, my daughter, my sister.
Somebody take the props away. And it's ready to serve. Lunch. I'm sorry, I mean fleshy fish melt.
It's an open sandwich.
That's it's a very,
very
nice
novel.
Open sandwich.
My two-year-old would love it because it's his favourite food, tuna sandwiches.
I love this, man. This is
I love tuna sandwich.
This dude doesn't care. He just serves up a tuna sandwich.
It's probably one of the favourite meals I've eaten so far this week. Gorgeous.
Nice one. Alex decides to swing conversation across to his acting career.
I love to get into a part and to hear.
Well, I've never. What acting have you done?
Plays.
What plays?
Play. I just did a play just recently. You have to elicit an emotional response from the audience night after night. And to get them to laugh.
Just laugh in his face, why don't you?
What is the most uncomfortable thing that you think Alex has done that you would have scolded him about?
God, where do we start?
No, I mean, is there a lot? No, but I mean...
I think he's fame-hungry. I think that he gets into high-profile relationships, sells every part of it, whether it's him or the people around him or the women he's doing it with.
Yeah.
But he likes it, and he's self-indulgent.
Don't hold back!
I actually couldn't help myself. It's like, Alex, you're fame-hungry.
Says the ex-Page 3 wag.
Even Nicola McLean said some not nice things. She said that I'm fame-obsessed, and I acknowledge that because I have been. And it's become like an addiction.
I'm sorry. If I offended you, I'm sorry.
I'm really not offended by any means. I'm curious.
No, but that's annoying. See, that,
come
do you know
as a prat,
it? No, listen to me. Listen. That's also annoying me, that you're not offended, because I think if someone thought I was... No, you're coming across as vulnerable.
He's a little boy, not knowing who he is. I'll try and help him out on that this week.
You're not his mother!
I can bust Sally's chops a little bit. I can see her picking a little bit on Alex. I'm the neutral ref. I love this guy. Here's the thing, Alex, you gotta listen. It does sound like if you're in a rut with this stuff...
Correct.
...then you just correct it a little bit.
Absolutely.
It was really, really great to have Robert. He was like a...
Having a friend?
What do you call it?
A chum. A mate.
An oasis. What do you call that? A rest bite. What do you call it? What's the name for that?
Wingman! Anyway, moving on to dessert, Robert combines ice cream, chocolate syrup and a fizzy drink. And it's served! Coke float! I mean, decaying sodas. And a chance for Robert to talk about his most famous character.
But the real glove is a rough gardening glove. Yeah, and you have to be careful. You know, you go for a bogey and you can hurt yourself. And you go to the bathroom, you forget you have the glove on, you change your religion.
Can I have a plate, please? I've always wanted a go.
Women love the glove.
Oh. They do not. Oh,
women really love the glove.
How does Freddy talk?
No, don't ask him.
Take a nap, Nick.
Here we go.
Daddy will see you soon. It's a dirty job, but someone's got to do it.
Oh, now that makes me fancy you.
See, Robert, different accents do work.
You're my girlfriend now, Nicky!
Oh, you've blown it.
The dessert weren't great, but, it's Freddy flipping Krueger.
I haven't really enjoyed the night, but that was more to do with Alex than Robert.
Mate, you're getting an 8.
I'm going to give him a 7.
It wasn't really what I would call a proper meal.
So first host Robert kicks off the week with a scarily respectable 20 points. It's day 2 of our celebrities' battle to win a grand for charity, and tonight's host Nicola's already made up her mind about one particular diner.
My least favourite guest wouldn't be hard to guess. It's definitely Alex, bless him. He's just not for me.
But Sally's feeling more sympathetic.
I might have been a bit too harsh with him, but he's like a child.
A bit patronising. What do you think?
There was a lot of attention on subjects to do with me last night, and I was like, oh, okay, this is not so pleasant. I'd rather it have been a bit more jovial and light, and I'm just trying to be my fun self.
Long may that last! Nicola begins by whisking eggs.
It's like an Olympic sport beating these eggs. I need a sports bra on.
Crikey! They're for her dessert, bloody tart.
Well, she is a bloody tart, isn't she? I'm teasing. I love her.
Caster sugar, ground almonds, and butter are combined before whisking.
Amazing.
So modest. Nicola spreads cherry jam and her mixture into the pastry.
I don't really have to be on my knees to do this. I'm just a bit weird.
You said it. Tart ready, she gets on with her Halloween starter, hellfire soup.
I like spices, you know. Not too spicy, just a little bit.
Nicola roasts pumpkin with red onion and garlic, then spices with chilli.
I'm going to leave the seeds in one of the peppers as well, because that's the hot thing, isn't it?
Yes, you might regret that. She blends the lot before trying it.
Oh, my God. Oh. Oh, my God. too hot to eat.
Yep, I told you. If your lips are made of asbestos, you can find Nicola's recipe on the Channel 4 website and save it into your own online scrapbook. Soup done, she moves on to her main, foul green curry.
I'm not a lover of curry.
Now, is that foul because it tastes disgusting, or foul as in chicken?
It's a mystery! Nicola fries red onion and adds Thai green paste.
So I've got to cook this until it gets fragrant. I don't really know what that means, so I'll just cook it until I think it's fragrant.
Exactly. In goes coconut milk. Nicola. It's all right, that's normal. It's okay, Nick.
Is that normal?
Yes!
That's not normal, is it?
It is normal.
Maybe it is normal.
It is normal. Stir it in. There you go. She adds fish sauce, lime leaves and simmers. Nicola will add chicken later. And there's a vampish theme tonight.
Fantastic. That's, it's great for the girls. They can look very sexy.
Permit me to introduce myself. I want to suck your...
Yeah, you missed him. Nicola has time to vamp herself up before guest number one arrives. It's Count Dracula. That's right, ham it up, Robert.
Hello!
Is this the right place?
Well, what do you think? He's quickly followed by a guilt-ridden Sally.
Hello! Hi, look at you! Look at you!
I love your makeup.
Last in, the man Sally wants to apologise to, Alex. Oh, I think your makeup's run, fella.
Oh, my God!
Is it Abe Lincoln meets the Matrix?
Oh, my God! You know I don't like scary things! Really,
Alex did look amazing.
She's really scared.
Yeah, it may be time to quit the act, Alex.
I actually thought this dude probably would bite me. You know, he would think that that was socially acceptable.
Well, he is a vampire. Better feed him while he's hungry. Bring out the hellfire soup!
This is really, really
What's
nice.
What's the grass is one?
Grass bits?
Rosemary. Makes I think you've won it, Nick.
A prediction, Sally.
Absolutely. Blown by the soup, mate.
You're not the only one.
Mm. This is hot, isn't it? We're chilling.
Do you think it's really hot?
Yeah, I do.
Oh, no, I'm so sorry.
I think it's just right.
It's absolutely gorgeous, darling.
Just right.
It isn't your fault that I can't take very, very hot stuff.
That's not the only thing she's sorry about.
I want to apologise. It's just literally because I look at you and you're so childlike in a way. I want to protect you. You're very, 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 very vulnerable. And I find that very endearing, so, you know.
But also annoying.
What, you're annoying? Oh, incredibly annoying. You are incredibly annoying.
Where did that apology go?
You don't listen because you're not taking anything on board, because it goes in one ear and straight out the other.
I do very much listen.
No, you don't.
I do.
You don't.
Oh, I'm probably mothering him.
Oh, just a bit.
She keeps saying I'm vulnerable, and I'm like... I'm not vulnerable.
On with the main. Nicola cooks through some chicken in her Thai green sauce and hey presto, foul green curry.
It's great. I was worried it was going to be really hot.
No.
And this is such an accomplishment. I'm just so impressed. Yummy.
The food's a hit. Time for some intellectual conversation.
What is snogging?
No.
Kiss him.
Yeah.
With the tongues.
No. Why does it have to be tongues?
Because that's
only
nice.
Want to cuddle.
That you're still, you know, getting it on when you're a bit older.
Oh, well, you can still get it on.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Although my hips, my left hip place, I've got a dodgy hip.
Somebody better get a nice Christmas present.
I've had two children.
Quite... I know. Well, that's how I got three children by
no,
that.
No, but I'm weird a little bit because you're making me laugh.
I know.
That happens.
Yeah.
What was that?
It does. It stress incontinence.
Do you guys find that you're a little hornier in hotel rooms than you are at your own home?
No, I don't.
No?
No. No. She's peed her pants.
Oh.
Yeah.
She just peed a little bit.
Peed her pants. She's going to need tenners tomorrow. And I don't mean a £10 note.
My pelvic floors aren't what they used to be. I was laughing so much, I did dribble a little bit of wee out.
Oh, lovely. And things are about to get even messier.
We're vampires tonight, so we're going to suck some blood.
You heard right. Whoever sucks the quickest from the baby bottle is the winner.
Where's my nipple?
It's an inverted one.
Get on with it.
Straight in there.
win, win, win.
Oh, dear.
And, you know, and then, oh, made a bit of a mess.
Why are you squeezing it out, Alex?
It's just fruit juice.
It's a very hard nipple. I knew you'd win. I predicted that.
Oh, wait, look. He's already won.
Has he got vodka in it?
Has he?
One. Look. Okay, oh. I have not spilled the drink.
But I spilled way too much.
Shall I wind you,
please,
Alex?
Please, yeah, please, right. Mommy. Come on. There you go.
That's just wrong. Very, very wrong.
Alex, it's like 35 years since I last had a baby, but there you go. No, it was brilliant.
I sort of wanted to mother me a bit tonight, and I played to it.
I declare you
the winner!
Yeah, I think this is fair.
Nicola's queen of the suckers, and she's hoping she'll also triumph with her pud. Bloody tart.
This is so, so delicious. How did you know this is my favourite?
Is it?
This is everything I love and everything I want.
Delicious.
Oh.
Praise indeed. Nicola's intrigued about Alex's cross-dressing alter ego, Roxanne.
Okay. I'm just wondering if you're going to come as Roxanne on any of the other nights.
No, Roxanne, I've kind of later bed.
Really? Okay, so that name or just dressing up as a woman?
In general.
That's not true.
Oh, there you go.
You cannot put that side of you to bed. It's part of you.
Please respect.
I do respect.
I don't. Also, you know, it's caused me two relationships.
So we're not going to see Roxanne.
We're not going to see Roxanne.
That's absolutely fair enough.
Yeah.
What about Suzanne?
Get out while you can, Alex.
I don't quite understand the fascination with the nation and Roxanne. I mean,
well, three people.
Alex kind of never gives a satisfactory answer because he's always waiting to sell it to a magazine.
Meow! Scores, please.
I give Nick an 8.
I thought her food was excellent.
It could have been a 10. If it wasn't for the boring Roxanne questions.
So, straight-talking vamp Nicola should have bitten her tongue, but she still takes the lead with 24. Coming up, shocking surprises.
Alex Reid jumps out at me. It can't get much worse than that.
Risqué revelations.
Do you want an exclusive? I've had a boob job.
Oh.
I've got a new belly button.
And tantalising food.
The little baby coffins for the shrimp. Oh, my, come on. That was Tim Burton worthy.
It's day three of our celebrity Halloween special, and the turn of Sally, I talk to the dead Morgan, to host her dinner party. And this morning, she's in a reflective mood.
I think on the first night, I did feel a little bit awful. I think that I may have picked on Alex a little bit, and I apologised to him last night.
I hope tonight there will be a bit more common decency, and it won't be all focused on Alex Roxanne Reid.
You and me both.
I just find Alex really strange. I just don't know where I am with him. I don't know what he's thinking and what he's going to say, and I just think he's a bit of a...
I think Nicola's definitely on Alex's case. Yeah, I think it's like he's like a splinter in her foot.
She'd better bring the tweezers. Sally begins with her main course, Night of the Pigging Dead.
Yum, yum, yum. Bacon! Daddy likes his pork.
Somebody not had breakfast.
Sounds dreadful, but it's probably going to be something amazing, like a slow-cooked pork.
Full marks!
This is my Night of the Pigging Dead, which is a rolled shoulder of pork, and I'm now putting some salt, a little bit of oil on it, which just makes the crackling really nice and...
Crackly?
Crispy.
Right. The joint will be roasted and served with roast vegetables.
Bye-bye.
She does talk to the dead. Next up, her starter, prawn of the dead.
Sounds good, like prawn cocktails, anything like that. I was actually thinking of doing that myself.
Too late now.
John? John!
Who's John?
John!
Lost your husband?
He's upstairs. Well, I need these langoustine. John! Where have you been?
Upstairs with the langoustine. Where else?
Oh, look at those. I'm going to serve my langoustine in little coffin tins tonight. Spooky. Look at that one. Can you imagine that? Hanging out of the coffin.
Sally sees to John's catch on a griddle. Once cooked, it's chilled to be served later. Finally, she moves on to dessert. Death by chocolate, R.I.P.
A chocolate cake, I'm imagining, with chocolate sauce and more chocolate, which will be yummy.
Oh, you are funny!
There's nothing nicer than homemade ice cream.
So I hear.
So that's what I'm going to make now. That's okay with you?
Yeah, fine, whatever you want. She adds sugar to cream and milk before melting chocolate in a bain-marie.
Martha, would you like some ice cream Mummy's making?
Oh, yes.
Would you like some chocolate ice cream?
Oh, yes.
You can't have it.
What?
No. Naughty girl.
Not fair. Sally adds the melted chocolate to the mix, then whisks.
John would really love to lick this bowl because he loves chocolate.
That's the husband, right?
But he's got too much of a tummy. He's not going to do it. I'm not allowing it.
She leaves to churn before moving on to the spongy bit.
I wish we had smell-o-vision because you can really smell the chocolate in this. It's delicious.
She dices her pre-made cake, adds almond liqueur, crushed nuts and more of that melted chocolate. Good on you, John. Bad luck, Pooch.
Aww. All I've got to go and do now is become a zombie.
That won't take long.
Tonight's dress code? The living dead. Oh, I must get out my pale base.
I think that I'll go as a mummy, because I am a mummy.
Ingenious!
I'm so funny.
No, you're not.
The living dead.
Well done. Oh, here she comes. Looking a bit peaky, mind, but not as much as this lot. And first up, crikey, who's this beast?
I don't even know who that is, but he just grabbed my boots.
I can't breathe!
No, it's Alex Reid!
Oh, God. Oh, that was good.
That was good. When what? Nicola comes, she is going to absolutely
I'm gonna
freak.
Scare the out of
yes, she is.
And heading in next is slasher movie legend Robert Freddy Krueger Englund.
Ghost riders in.
Am I in the right place, Sally?
You are in the right place, Sally.
Am I the first one? I'm trying to get a head start.
Head start!
The headless what is this?
The headless horseman.
The headless horseman, of course. I never thought I'd be saying I'm in love with a zombie, but
now,
I am, and a headless horseman.
Like
you know how
movies.
Scary and scared Nicola gets.
Yes.
I'm here, darling! Don't worry!
Don't
worry, darling! Come in, my darling! Get out, zombies! Go away!
Yes, get back to drama school!
Those things were so freaky out there and they're trying to grab me.
Aren't they freaky? There you are. Don't worry.
No! Oh, here he goes! Everybody calm down!
I sit down with a glass of champagne thinking, well, this is getting better. And Alex Reid jumps out at me. It can't get much worse than that.
Feeling your pain.
Here's to a foolish,
happy,
scary night.
Happy zombie night, yeah.
For her starter, Sally adds avocado and caviar, then lays the chilled langoustine to rest in tiny little coffins for her prawn of the dead.
Gosh, oh, look. My goodness.
That is
so
the nuts.
I can't believe it. There's caviar.
Is it okay eating
yeah,
it?
It's gorgeous.
Look. Sally, this is so fresh.
The little baby coffins for the shrimp. Oh, my, come on. That was Tim Burton worthy.
Do you want an exclusive?
Oh, go on then.
Yeah.
I lost 88 kilos.
Hold the front page.
I've had a boob job just to make them higher. Mm-hmm. And they removed 5.5 pounds of skin off my tummy.
More shrimp, anyone?
So I've got a flat tummy now.
Oh,
and I've got a new belly button.
Nice.
For me, I've only had my boobs done, which I've had done twice, and I just like really big boobs.
You're not the only one.
Do you have to get them redone?
Oh, it all depends, doesn't it? I think they're kind of guaranteed life, I think.
Yeah. I hope you've kept the receipt.
Our society's all about image, and this is how you're supposed to look. Being beautiful and good-looking doesn't really make you get a lot of trouble, really. Because you're not taken seriously.
Well, no, you're taken seriously, but you never know what somebody
wants you for. That's not been a problem for me.
Never been a problem for me either, Paige.
You're actually quite a good-looking bird.
Thank you, darling. That's very, very kind of you.
If I was the same age...
Where's this going?
I'd probably, you know, and you were single, I'd have a go.
Good heavens!
I would. I'd be all over you.
Tell it. What is he like? You know, at the end of the day, I'm in my 60s and he's in, what is he, 30? I don't know how old he is. Or in his 30s, so it's never going to happen. So, you know.
Well, it would get you back in the papers. For her main, Sally stuffs her roasted veg inside a baked squash before shredding pork.
Sally T. When you do 7-hour pork, if you need a knife, then it's not cooked enough. Look at that. That's how that should be.
And here it is, Night of the Pigging Dead.
Bravo!
Oh my god.
Look at those carrots. It's such a harvest.
Oh, yeah, this is so sexy.
Autumnal meal. Oh.
Well done.
I've never had pork that good. It was remarkable.
Sublime meat.
I have to say, the pork was amazing. So it was just amazing.
I got the impression.
Meanwhile, Robert's sharing his thoughts about raising kids.
But I think we coddle children too much now.
You don't have kids.
I've watched children get fatter and stupider in the last 20 years.
Yeah.
Because of a spoiling of children. Children never ran up and down the aisles of airplanes in the 1960s. And now parents. People are parenting. They think, we don't want my child to cry. Let them run up and down the aisle.
Okay. So if my child doesn't want to sit down, well, I'm not going to make it.
I don't think that's right, Nick.
This dude is from Hollywood. He doesn't have any children. He's extremely intelligent, and he thinks he knows everything. You're not a dad. You're not a parent. You don't know everything.
I argue with Nicola tonight. And I'm childless. I'm childless because I didn't get married till I was 40, and I was, like, on tour doing movies for 10 years, and I didn't want to raise kids at 50. That's just me.
I really like Robert. I mean, sometimes he talks so much you can't understand almost what he's saying.
Mom and Dad don't want to fight with him.
I like to think I've reasonably cultured. I feel like if I was with him for a week, my IQ would go up by, you know, at least 10.
Well, 11 is still way below average, Alex. Back at the table.
The problem is, it's so good.
Wait,
what?
What are you...
Oh, Sally, please, no.
Look what's going on here. Look, there's more of them.
Whoa! Zombie children, and they're dancing on the patio.
They were unbelievable. It was so much fun. It's got to be one of the best things I've ever seen in my life.
I've got the freedom. Maybe I won't sing it.
That's a relief. Dessert's ready anyway. Death by chocolate, R.I.P.
Oh, my God.
Look at my tombstone.
This is bloody, bloody amazing.
I'm going to just pour some cream over it.
It's not a race, Alex.
Is it nice?
That's really good. I mean, that's really, really good.
We know. Taxis!
The dessert was amazing. Sally has literally pulled out all the stops. It was unbelievable.
I have such a chocolate high right now, I can't describe it to you.
If I had to mark myself, it's not surprising, is it? I'd give myself a 10. Actually, I'd give myself a 12 because of the effort that has gone into this.
Sally's night was amazing. Her entertainment was great, but I didn't like the starter, so I'm going to score her a 9.
It's a 9, but only because it was too good and I'm in pain now because I ate too much.
Pig meat, caviar and chocolate.
So Sally's guests were thrilled by her entertainment and food, meaning she takes the lead with a whopping 27 with one night to go. It's the final day of our Halloween special, and last on the bill is fledgling druid Alex Reid. Alex is in between celebrity girlfriends and their houses, so he's borrowed a friend's place to host.
I'm a little bit worried, because Sally cooked such a fabulous meal. And so did the others. So, you know, I'll have to come up to standard. I want to be in the competition.
I don't think his food stands a chance of winning. It's just something about him. I think that there's quite a sloppy side to him where that's concerned.
I don't really enjoy him, so I'm going to enjoy his evening very much.
I'd kind of like to be a fly in the wall and see what he's up to. You know, see what he's putting in the pot.
You'll soon find out. Alex begins with his main course. Sacrificial goat.
Is that like halal?
No.
I've had goat in Greece. I wonder if Alex has ever been to Greece.
I imagine he's seen the film.
I'm going to let you into a little secret. I've actually never cooked this before.
Uh-oh! He sweats an onion in clarified butter before moving on to the meat.
This, my culinary succulent... No, God, I'm trying to be too clever.
Oh, that's what it was. Alex covers the goat chops in Moroccan spices.
Right, dudes, we're going in.
To the meat, he adds tinned tomato.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Chopped garlic and a whole lot more.
That's a lot of garlic. I'm definitely going to be kissing people tonight. I'm the Redonator.
The Redonator then adds chicken stock, sweet potato and apricots.
A few hours' time, you're going to be delish.
Next, he moves on to his starter. Crunchy, crawling salad.
Oh, your hands are cold. If Alex had any chance of winning me over tonight, I really don't think a crunchy, crawling salad is going to do it.
Oh, these better not be bugs or anything. I won't be able to eat it.
I just hope they're open-minded.
Not sure they are. Alex begins with the dressing.
I don't know the exact amounts of certain things, but I'm just going to get on with it and go for it. Whack a bit of that in there. Do you know what? Let's do the lot.
Bad idea! He adds honey and olive oil.
Honey, honey. This is how I make it, to taste. I love it, Vic.
Well, they say you are what you eat. Bit mustardy.
I like it.
Fibber. He'll construct the crunchy crawling bit tonight and also prepare his dessert. Chilled bloody mess, just before serving.
Oh, it's just disgusting. I feel ill even looking at this menu.
I hope it's not plasma.
With prep done, Druid Alex has just enough time to change for this evening's rituals.
Dress code. Pagan party. I'm not taking my shirt off.
Don't tell me it's anything to do with orgies. Oh, my goodness me.
Let's just hope you're wrong. First through his goat obstacle course is Nicola. Is there anything you're not scared of?
And what's all this screaming about?
Oh, what have you got, goats?
Well, what did you think? Come on.
That's awful.
Oh, you look a sexy druid.
Next to arrive, the High Priest of Horus.
Satanic rituals.
Robert.
I told you I've had enough!
Wow, you look fan bloody tastic.
For you, my friend, I know. I'm the dark vicar.
Come on in.
Don't worry, darling, I'm not going to eat you tonight.
And last in, TV psychic Sally Morgan.
Let's go knock at the door. Do not fraternise with the goats.
You're fraternised, big word for you.
Drink.
Come in here, sweetheart.
Behave yourself, you.
You look gorgeous.
Oh, please, take this.
Oh, thank you.
Cheers to Alex.
Alex.
The last night.
Coming up. Feline frights.
Oh, my God.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God, he's gone nuts.
No.
The cat's gone nuts.
There was a really genuine spooky moment in there this evening.
Female forgiveness.
It made me think, Nicola, you're getting him all wrong.
And the results are revealed.
In second place, it's gonna be...
Cheers to Alex.
It's the final night of our horror-themed contest, and host Alex Reid is throwing a pagan party in the hope of winning £1,000 for charity.
The ultimate fighter, the ultimate meal.
Oh, yeah.
He gets going on his starter by sprinkling bugs over a garden salad. Available in specialist stores, folks. No, really.
Sun-dried, morpain caterpillars. Never tried one, but there's always a first.
I'm guessing that's not like chicken.
This is a delicacy.
No, it's a caterpillar. And there's some more of them on his crunchy, crawly salad. Good luck, ladies.
I can't eat any of that. I don't even want that in front of me. I'll eat the bread.
Thai green curry crickets. Just try one. No. Please. It doesn't taste as much.
I'm fine with a cricket.
It's fine.
I'm fine.
I'm not too keen on this.
It was horrible. It was terrible. They tasted like a charcoal briquette, you know, with urine on it.
Eat a lot of them, do you?
I'm sorry, I can't eat it.
There's nothing to be sorry about.
There were bugs on that salad that John gives to our chickens.
I could eat that. It's not. It wouldn't be a problem. I just don't under. Like, I don't actually, want to you, eat worms.
These actually, it just tastes like crisps. Actually,
nice salad and crisps.
Would you want a salad with nothing on it?
That looks beautiful to me. Thank you so much.
Water.
He was so sweet the way he brought me out a salad without bugs, and it made me think, Nicola, you're getting him all wrong.
You change your tune easily. Now Alex attempts to impress with some choice pearls of wisdom.
Basically, there's more we don't know about than we do know about this planet. Oh,
definitely. Tell me about it.
And I look at a mobile phone and I can talk to someone in China. I'm like, how does that work?
Satellites.
Yeah, a few hundred years ago, that's magic. I can get a piece of metal and fly to another country. It's just magic, unexplained.
Aeroplanes.
I've got a philosophical question about the sea and everything. Do you think we evolved from germs?
He's so sweet. A philosophical question about the sea and everything. Well, do you see when I want to squeeze?
Well, do you believe in evolution?
Yeah.
I think that Alex's attempt at being philosophical is his way of saying to everyone, look, there is depth within me, and I do want to be taken seriously, which I think is really endearing. But at the same time, when we find things endearing in a child that we know other people would laugh at, we need, in a very kind way, to let them know that. Otherwise, they're going to grow up deluded.
Yes, I'm just wondering whether that's the most patronising thing I've ever heard.
I think we're all done. Everyone done?
Yeah. I haven't been touched and can eat that.
Look, she can't even touch them.
Who would want
that?
Oh, dear. My adventurous, creeping, crawling salad didn't go down too well.
What were you expecting?
We've always got round two.
Seconds out, sacrificial goat, served in a baked pumpkin with couscous.
Mmm.
Alex, this is amazing, and I'm really impressed.
Mm. Oh, the sacrificial goat. I'm telling you, it was really good. Really good.
It's lovely. The only problem I have... The problem I have...
Let me tell you what it is. You know what it is.
What?
It's goat.
The problem I have is it smells like a sheep, like lamb.
Oh, really?
It
smells
like a lamb.
Okay.
Yeah.
Why are you so anti-lamb? Oh, hello.
It's a goat.
Oh, my God.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God, he's got nuts. No. The cat's got nuts.
All over the plumbing. Oh, no.
What is it?
Red wine on the carpet.
There is a spirit in this house.
There's also a cat.
That every now and again decides to make itself prominent.
Meow, here I am.
There was a really genuine spooky moment in there this evening. The cat was definitely spooked by a presence.
I'll take a day off.
So far, the food hasn't gone down massively well.
Better luck with dessert then. Alex adds meringue and raspberries to whipped cream.
I like it.
Good for you. And there it is, chilled bloody mess.
That is amazing.
This is delicious.
So impressed.
It's amazing. I love this dry ice. I love ice cream. I'm an ice cream freak. It definitely cleansed my palate because I still had an aftertaste of lamb.
It was goat and you didn't touch it.
Delicious. It was really, really nice and I was really impressed with the dry ice and it just looked unbelievable. I feel so bad, I've got to be honest, because tonight... If I've met you, like, you've been so lovely, you really have. I think that you're genuinely a really nice guy. I do think that you're a bit immature, and that's not a bad thing.
No.
Because I feel like I want to mother you.
Me, you bring that out in me. I want to sort of, like, protect you. And part of protecting you is trying to tell you where you're going wrong.
I don't want mothers. I've already got a mother, you know, and the last thing I want is another mother.
I don't think they're actually offering. Alex will need to beat Sally's score of 27 if he's to come out on top.
I just don't want the guy to get hung out to dry, OK? And I know the girls are going to beat him up, so I'm giving him an 8.
The food was inedible.
but he has won me over, bless him. He seemed like a really sweet guy.
The starter and the main course for me was disastrous, but the dessert has saved him. I'm going to give Alex.
Who's gonna be the winner?
Okay.
Who wants to be the winner?
You do, Alex. Go on, you can win.
Good luck.
In third place, Alex. Alex and Robert! See, I don't want to play this game anymore.
I'm proud to be your girl, man. I'm gonna go out.
In second place, it's gonna be Nicola! Having Sally on a winner! Woo! Oh my God!
Congratulations, Sally.
You get the money! Well, there you go. I've shared a cooking accolade with Freddy Flippin' Krueger.
Yep, last place. All right, that's supposed to be for charity.
No, darling, that's an expensive cleavage.
I wanted to win, but let's be honest, no one was ever going to beat Sally, and she really deserved to win.
Do new friends.
Just dance as a little girl. I tell you what, I'm happy, really, that I came above Rob, simply because that was a piece of bread with tin tuna on it. Hello.
Bon appetit!
The Monster Mash.
The Monster Mash.
And you my graveyard smash.
Darren Brown's mission to make one man believe in apocalypse continues Friday at 9. Get caught up with episode 1 on 4OD. Coming up, they're used to a crofter's cottage on Sky. Forget it. One very different build about to pop up in Grand Designs.